As developers, we know that search is a solved problem. We introduce a dedicated search database, such as Elasticsearch or a search service like Algolia. Then we ensure to write the product name and description to the search database so that we can leverage the advanced search functionality to deliver a better user experience and solve the problem. Right? Well, no. Unfortunately, it's not that simple. As soon as we start making updates to more than one database, we run into the dual write problem. We all know that a network request or an application can fail, and it's important that to make sure that when this happens, we don't leave an inconsistent state behind. When working with databases, we can normally depend on transactions to take care of this. But transactions only work in the scope of a single database. So in this scenario, what could happen is that a new product is added to the application database, but before it's added to Elasticsearch, the application fails. This means that the new product isn't searchable, although it's available. The solution to this problem is to write to the primary database and have the data propagated to the search database in a consistent manner. A popular way to achieve this is using the change data capture pattern. The industry standard for implementing this is called Debezium, which is built on top of Apache Kafka. We are looking to extend the Prisma Data Platform to support this pattern in a way that is optimized for serverless applications while still being compatible with industry standards. Okay, that was a lot of theory. What I'm about to show you is a very early concept of how we expect this to work. So keep in mind, while the syntax is just an example, we want the overall flow to be very close to the final product. If this sounds useful to you, then we'd love to hear from you so that we can make sure to incorporate your ideas and requirements into our final design. Okay, let's jump in. Here's a simplified Prisma schema showing the models relevant for this example. The first step is to introduce a new data source along with the product search index model in the Prisma schema. We use Elasticsearch in this example, but you can imagine doing this with your favorite search service. Note that Prisma currently only supports a single data source, but connecting it to multiple data sources is something we are considering adding soon. With this, you could already implement the dual write pattern by manually updating the data in both databases. But as we discussed, we need something better to avoid data inconsistency. Now, we want to take data from the first data source and project it into this new Elasticsearch index. We'll do that by defining a projection that is responsible for propagating changes. With this syntax, we define that the values of certain fields in the product model should be automatically propagated to the product search index in the Elasticsearch database. Under the hood, the Prisma Data Platform takes care of all the plumbing so you can focus on your business logic of your application. With these changes, I can now create a new pull request that contains this data projection. Creating the PR will trigger creation of a new preview environment. However, our preview environment creation will fail since we haven't defined our connection details to our Elasticsearch database. So let's go ahead and do that. Any project on the Prisma Data Platform has the ability to define multiple environments so that this is easy to customize settings for these. We can now go ahead and define the new preview environment variable to fix the problem. Now we're all set. The PR is green. We can go check out the details how this works by clicking on details. In the project view, I can look at the data projection I just added. And then I'll trigger the backfilling of existing data into the product search index. We can check out the backfilling happening here and verify that the data is being pushed into Elasticsearch with every change. And with that, our search issue from earlier is resolved. We can now rest assured that the search works and we don't lose revenue or hair over this. So let's recap what we've been envisioning here. With a couple of changes on the Prisma schema, we would be able to create data projections across data sources almost instantly. This allows you to forget about the infrastructure components needed to make this happen. Prisma would provision, operate, and monitor the infrastructure needed to make this happen, namely the components required for the change data capture pattern, as well as the persistent queue for offering a fully integrated alternative for Debezium and Kafka. This would guarantee that the application and such databases are always in a consistent state and enable straightforward backfilling when the data projection is deployed. You can imagine other usages for this, like building real-time subscriptions, projecting results of a complex query to a caching layer, or projecting data to a reporting system. Now.